Steve Dotto here. How the heck are you this fine day? Me, I'm feeling quite fulfilled because my Evernote group, I've got a Evernote community on Facebook, which is there to support this great course that I'm delivering. But my Evernote community is giving me great ideas for demos. What's the great idea today? Paperless office, a tool for the paperless office, a service that makes the paperless office, they claim, effortless. And you know something? They just might be right. Check out File This today on Dotto Tech. All right, before we begin today, I need to do a quick shout out to my Patreon supporters. As many of you know, Dotto Tech is a community-funded site. We are supported by the generosity of the people who view the channel here, and those people are represented on Patreon. That's the crowdfunding site where people come, they put a few dollars a month in to make sure that I can afford to keep this channel going. So to all of you who support the channel, thank you so much. If you're interested in finding out about how to support this channel, we'll drop by our Patreon page and have a look. For as little as a dollar a month, you can make sure that Dotto Tech continues unabated. Now, we've got this Facebook group for Evernote Made Easy, which is the Evernote course that we've been delivering for a little while now, and it's going gangbusters. There's tons of people in the group exchanging lots of ideas and information about Facebook, and I'll probably be coming back to this group quite often in future videos because they're offering me some wonderful suggestions. Now, the suggestion that they offered me this week that I want to take a look at is around the paperless office, and it's a service called FileThis. And when I took a quick look at it, I was pretty impressed for a couple of reasons. One is they seem to have kind of a unique take on helping you with common documents, things like bills and invoices, things that you get on a monthly basis, and putting them in one place for you. Now, you can create filters and stuff like that as you receive messages by email or invoices or statements by email. You can create filters and store them in Evernote and other places. But what FileThis does is it takes your documents, the common documents that you get, the bills, and it files them all in one place. It automatically, but what it does is it retrieves them for you. It'll retrieve them for you, and then it will store them either on their server, and they give you about 500 megabytes, which is a lot of space for documents, or they also will store them in one of your cloud services. So you can store them in Evernote, you can store them in Box, you can store them in Dropbox or Google Drive. It's your choice. And they file them logically so you can quickly find them. And they've got dozens of companies that they are retrieving your documents from. So I thought what we might do is set it up together, because it's in the setup that a lot of people kind of bump their heads. They go, I don't know if I want to go through the whole setup process. It sounds like it's going to be difficult. Let's do it together, shall we? So before I begin, it's free to sign up, and they've got a pretty robust free service. Take a look here. The free service allows up to 6 connections per month. Or having up to 6 connections, sorry. So you can think of your MasterCard bill, your hydro or your electric bill. Each of those would be classified as a connection. It runs once a week, and it allows you up to 500 megabytes of storage. So that's free. Look at this. They say, this is our best value. Really? Free is the best you can do for me is free? Well, okay. Their premium service is $2 a month or $20 a year. I like that so many of these services are pricing themselves in this very reasonable range where, you know, it's a small payment, like less than you often pay monthly for other services. We see this with Task Clone that I showed you in a previous video. Some really nice services that do some really great things, and they keep them really affordable. So $20 for 3 years, or $20 for a year, and look, 12 connections. I think this is probably more practical for most of us when you think about the number of recurring bills that we're going to be getting. And it runs once a week. You don't need it to run all that more often, and up to a gigabyte of storage. And then for the ultimate is at $5 a month, or you can get it for $50 a year, about the same price as you'd pay for an Evernote connection. And it costs up to 30 connections, runs daily, and 10 gigabytes. And they've got different add-on packs that kind of go on above that. But it's really simple. All it does is it fetches your documents, files them, and allows you to find them quickly. So let's just kind of go through the setup process, shall we? So let me log in. Now, I have just signed up. I haven't done any setup. I've had a look at the service, kind of figured out kind of how it works. So you're going to see with me how you go about setting it up. Now, the first thing we need to do is choose our destination. So, of course, since we're Evernote folks on this kind of, I'm an Evernote kind of guy, I'm going to set it up to sync to Evernote. So connect this file to your Evernote account. When you click the authorize button, you'll be taken to the Evernote website, which allow it to authorize. This is pretty standard with setting up anything that has an API level integration with Evernote. So I'm going to just sign into my Evernote account, give it a year authorization. I've done this a few times with a few different apps, and now it's authorized to work with Evernote. Excellent. So that's step one. Step two is we need to start working with the different connections. Now, connections are basically institutions that we want to receive documents from. And here is where our demo goes slightly off the rails, because I live in Canada. It looks to me like FileThis is mainly a U.S. property, although there are certainly going to be a few accounts that I probably could find. Looking through the list of their accounts, there aren't Canadian institutions here. We don't have our civic taxes. We don't have our banks. There are a bunch of Canadian banks, but they're all the American versions of Canadian banks like TD and Bank of Montreal, but they're all the U.S. versions. So it doesn't look to me, unless I'm missing something and somebody emails something in or comments, that it's going to be great for people that don't live in the States. However, if you are an American living in the States, look at the services that you can draw your documents from. It looks like all of the financial institutions are there. They have popular ones. What are the popular ones? Amazon is there. Comcast, PayPal is there. We've got Verizon, so you've got your wireless services are there. All of the different financials are there. And this is the one that's going to be interesting to me, is utilities. Let's take a look at what utilities. And yeah, look at that. A lot of utilities. Well, not as many state utilities as I might have thought, or you know, power and stuff like that. But you've got some. You've got a goodly selection, and certainly the main financial institutions and the main merchants seem to be there. So all that happens now, if you want to gather information from any of these, if you want the system to go in and draw the documents out, is you choose one of them, and let's pretend that we want the Dish Network. You put in your user account information and your password, and then you click on the connect link. And what will happen is then it will go through a connection process and draw the documents out. It'll look for any current documents. And then once a week, it will be pulling the documents and it will store them either here in the cloud services in their document area, which we can't see because I don't have any documents. Or in this particular case, for me, it would migrate it directly into my service, my cloud service, which I chose as Evernote. So it will then draw the documents in automatically. It eliminates the need of me to receive an email with the statement, then file it in Evernote and do all of that filing information. I can't see exactly how the naming convention is going to work. So maybe somebody will post a comment that's using it on how the naming convention works and how easy it is for them to find the files in the future. But it does look to me like an outstanding service, especially the free level, which is, you know, for your main utility bills and your main financial bills and stuff like that, to have it automatically go in to your paperless office storage repository of choice, be it one of the cloud-based services or be it something like Evernote. I hoped I was able to show you a little bit more, but you know what? It looks like a good service as it is. I'm hoping someday they'll add more Canadian integration. That'll be something that we'll keep our eye on. But until they do, all of you American viewers, enjoy. Canadian viewers, let's just keep on emailing our stuff into Evernote for the time being. I hope you found this video today to be useful. There's three ways to stay in touch with us here on Dotto Tech. The first is please subscribe to our channel. The second, sign up for our newsletter. Then you'll hear about all of our different special upcoming events, like the series of webinars that I constantly deliver. And finally, you can sign up and be one of our supporters in Patreon, as I mentioned off the top of this video. But that's me for today. So until next time, have fun storming the castle.